Enterprise Information Management, also referred to by the acronym EIM, can be defined as a best practice for creating, managing, sharing, and leveraging information in an enterprise holistic manner that's aligned with strategic data-driven business objectives. This is a definition provided by Philip Russom from the Data Warehouse Institute. I prefer a simpler way of referring to it, and through team collaboration and tool interoperability, EIM seeks to improve the four C's of structured and unstructured data. Namely, these four C's are completeness, cleanliness, consistency, and currency. SQL Server has evolved to deliver EIM with a rich set of services designed to improve the overall relevance and value of organizational information. It empowers people to discover and resolve problems with data and to streamline existing data management processes by using familiar tools like Excel. It provisions and manages enterprise information. It can manage more effective data integration and management across the organization and ultimately deliver trusted information for business intelligence, data warehouse, and transaction processing workloads. SQL Server 2016 delivers EIM with three services: integration services, master data services, and data quality services, and I'll introduce all three of them in this presentation. These services can be installed on-premises or hosted inside a virtual machine. Together, these three services deliver enterprise information management. With a focus on integration services, it's primarily designed to implement extract, transform, and load processes. It provides a robust, flexible, fast, scalable, and extensible architecture. Master Data Services is designed to deliver master data management. It can manage reliable, centralized data, and it broadens its reach with an Excel add-in that can also be used with data quality services for data matching. And lastly, Data Quality Services is about data quality management. It's a knowledge-driven data cleansing product, and it supports the correction and deduplication of data. It can also correct data errors found within the integration services data flow. Together, these three services deliver complete, clean, and consistent and current data. Let's then focus on integration services. Integration Services is a platform for building enterprise-level data integration and data transformation solutions. It includes a rich set of built-in tasks and transformations, tools for constructing packages, and the SSIS service for running and managing packages. Integration Services was primarily designed to implement ETL processing. It provides that robust, flexible, fast, scalable, and extensible architecture with capabilities that move beyond just ETL processing. You may consider other scenarios like assessing data quality, cleansing and standardizing data, merging data from different data stores, implementing repetitive or ad hoc data transfers, or simply automating administrative tasks. From an architectural perspective, Integration Services is a service, and the service has two different runtime engines, the control flow and the data flow. Control flow is a process-oriented workflow engine, and a package, which is the unit of development and deployment, consists of a single control flow. Control flow elements can consist of variables, containers consisting of other control flow, tasks that perform discrete functionality, precedence constraints that determine the order or the conditions upon which tasks may execute, and also event handlers that can respond to runtime information. The data flow task encapsulates the second engine, the data flow engine. It is designed by connecting sources, destinations, and transforms. Let's take a look at an example of a data flow task that, when designed, could consist of a source to retrieve employee data, it could use a transformation component to look up a sales territory key. If a sales territory key doesn't exist, it outputs to an error path whereupon a component substitutes to an unknown key. The lookup records are then combined with those that have been corrected, and then they're output to a destination, which is the dimension table for employees. What we see here with this very simple data flow design, first of all, is a source to extract data, three components to transform data, and a destination to load. Note there the ETL, the extract transform load, could be implemented entirely within a single data flow task. There are many new features delivered with SQL Server 2016 integration services, including improvements to deployment, improvements for debugging, improvements for package management, the new control flow package parts that allow modular design and reuse of control flow logic, expanded on-premises connectivity to new sources and to new versions of sources, expanded cloud connectivity for hybrid scenarios working with Azure, and many, many more. You can download and install the Azure feature pack, and new features include connection managers, an enumerator, tasks, and data flow components for working with Azure resources. Let's take a look at an example. Here in the package designer, I could implement a design that includes a container for preparation, and we see here a task to upload files to an Azure Blob Store. Simultaneously, it creates a big data cluster with Azure HD Insight. It also uses an analysis services task to create a new model partition. On successful completion of all of these tasks, the container then moves forward to execute a Hive query on Azure HD Insight, and this could be used to stage data. It then triggers, upon success, the processing of the model partition. And then it goes ahead and deletes the Azure HD Insight cluster. And we see the entire orchestration here by using the components now available with the Azure feature pack. Integration Services 2016 is supported by Enterprise, Standard, and Developer Editions. The Import-Export Wizard built-in and Azure Data Source connectors and tasks are also supported by Web and Express editions. Hadoop and HDFS connectors and tasks are also supported by Web Edition. And supported only by Enterprise Edition includes the Change Data Capture Service and Designer for Oracle BioTunity, Advanced Adapters, Advanced Transforms. We recommend a number of resources, including MSDN resources, and also the Integration Services blog. There's also TechNet Virtual Lab. To explore what's new in SQL Server 2016 Integration Services, go ahead, use this URL, and use the search pane to locate the lab. This will expose you to all of the new capabilities delivered in the recent release of SQL Server. Now with a focus on Master Data Services. Master Data Services is a SQL Server service from Microsoft designed to implement and manage master data management solutions. It was first released with SQL Server 2008 R2, and then in SQL Server 2012 we saw many improvements to feature set and the user experience. In SQL Server 2014 there were no new capabilities or features, and in the most recent release with SQL Server 2016 it included many new capabilities and features. Note that it is supported by Enterprise Edition only in SQL Server 2016. However, for non-production use, it is also supported by Developer and Evaluation Editions. Let's focus on Master Data Management. Its acronym MDM is about taking control of data and making data work for the organization's advantage. It enables an organization to discover and define non-transactional lists of data and to compile maintainable, reliable master lists. A successful MDM solution delivers a master data hub that provides access to authoritative, standardized, and validated versions of data. It can also address many problems. The fact that you may have no authoritative source of data may lead to reports not being trusted or being used, resulting in poor decisions. Systems could have different versions of the same data, and somehow you need to surface for business intelligence a single version of the truth. Data could be spread across multiple systems that lack integrity and consistency. Mergers and acquisitions that involve integrating data will likely contribute to different versions of data. And it's likely that there is no formal dimension maintenance capability for the cubes and data models that you expose in your business intelligence platforms. There could be multiple stakeholders for the same record, and an inability to enable, monitor, and enforce data stewardship processes. MDM then can be implemented as operational MDM or analytical MDM. An operational MDM delivers a master data hub as a system of record and with a focus on integration achieved with centralized governance. We can see here that the data originates in a master data management system and could be ETL'd into other systems for analytic and reporting purposes or operational purposes. In contrast, analytical MDM delivers a single and consistent view of master data in the downstream data warehouse. Having implemented an analytical MDM solution, a master list of records can then become the dimension source. And as we can see here, multiple sources of data defining business entities like products and customers could be ETL'd into a master data management solution, and therefore maintained as the master set of data, and then this becomes the source by which we populate the dimensions in the data warehouse. Master Data Services is implemented as a WCF data service. It requires Internet Information Services, or IIS, and that becomes the host for the web application and web service. Master Data Services can be programmatically manipulated. It requires a repository of metadata and data, which is a SQL Server database, and this database can be created on either a local or remote computer. Microsoft provides two user interfaces. The first is a web application named Master Data Manager. The second is an Excel add-in. Here's a sample implementation. Having source systems, the traditional approach would be to use an ETL tool like Integration Services and populate source data direct into a data warehouse. We'd ask you to reconsider this design. By installing Master Data Services, you could initialize a set of master data from the source system, and this could be achieved by using a tool like Integration Services. And then moving forward, the administration and data changes could be achieved direct with Master Data Services and achieved with the user interface of Master Data Manager or Excel. You could benefit from new features like business rules and notifications that can advise you or alert you to the fact that business rules are broken. And then you could adapt your ETL process to source no longer from the operational system, but from the master lists in Master Data Services. Master Data Services can integrate with Integration Services. We can import master data simply by loading data into SQL Server tables. These are staging tables, and then there is a procedure that will then load and validate that data as master list. It's very simple then to export master data, which is achieved by retrieving data from SQL Server views. Master Data Services can also integrate with DQS. We'll explore this in the next topic. There are many new features with SQL Server 2016. Improved user interfaces, improved permission management, improved performance and scale, improvements to business rules including custom T-SQL logic, merge conflict detection and resolution, change sets to enable approval workflows, improvements to hierarchies. There's also entity sync to enable the sharing of common entities between models, and many, many more features in addition. We list here several resources, including features supported by edition of SQL Server 2016. So I'll remind you that this is an enterprise edition feature only. There are also two virtual labs that could interest you. Available on TechNet, the first lab is developing a SQL Server 2016 Master Data Services solution. And that is great for anybody that is new to Master Data Services and provides an end-to-end discovery of what this service can achieve. The second lab focuses incrementally on the new features that were added to SQL Server 2016 Master Data Services. Now with a focus on data quality services. Data quality services is a knowledge-driven data cleansing product, and it is a product dedicated to data correction, standardization, enrichment, and matching. It was first released with SQL Server 2012, We saw in SQL Server 2014 that no new capabilities or features were added, and this is also the case with SQL Server 2016. It is supported by Enterprise Edition only. For non-production use, however, it is also supported by Developer and Evaluation Editions. Architecturally, it is all driven by the knowledge base, and this knowledge base is the accumulation of knowledge in the form of values and rules and relations that define how to cleanse and standardize your data. We build knowledge bases using knowledge management processes. We can discover data from consistent quality stores of data that we already have, and we can use this data to build up values and rules. We can also build matching policies that can assist with the deduplication of data. This knowledge base can accumulate and change over time with improvements as you fine-tune the data and the rules to support your cleansing activities. When it comes to using data quality services, there are two approaches. There's a cleansing project that supports the cleansing or standardization of data, and there is the matching project that can be used for the deduplication of your data. The outputs of either project can be stored in SQL Server or output to Excel or CSV formats. And this overall process can be monitored through integrated profiling and supports auditing and also review. There are numerous benefits to using data quality services, including accumulating cleansing and matching knowledge in a knowledge base, updating cleansing and matching knowledge as required, leveraging built-in functionality and algorithms to cleanse and match data, applying consistent cleansing logic, and automating cleansing activities that results in reduced time, cost, and the potential for human error. There's also integration with the other EIM services delivered with SQL Server. DQS can integrate with integration services. There is the DQS Cleansing Dataflow Transform available with Integration Services 2012 and later. Here's an example of a Dataflow task designed to retrieve office data. It uses the DQS cleansing to connect to a knowledge base and apply cleansing logic, and the output results in cleansed data, including statistics. Using a conditional split, we can determine those records that were correct or were corrected, as opposed to those that were invalid. And then we could handle these through different tables. DQS can also integrate with Master Data Services. The Master Data Services add-in for Excel can be used to help identify duplicate members before they are published to an entity. We see here on the ribbon the two commands to match data and to show specific details. Data quality services in 2016 includes no new features. Here are several resources, and a great resource is the Data Quality Services Technical Reference, which is available for download as a PDF. In summary, SQL Server 2016 continues to deliver a comprehensive enterprise information management platform with three services: Integration Services, Master Data Services, and Data Quality Services. They function independently and also in integrated designs. Together, they form the SQL Server 2016 Enterprise Information Management Platform. And collectively, they deliver complete, clean, consistent, and current data.